This is what we have developed in the last class, and right, it's a P. R minimum is, or in the denominator. Is when sine theta is equal to 1 or theta is equal to 0 degrees. P is equal to, it's square over mu to 1 plus 1, 1 over 1 plus E. I mean, you really have to do that. Right, let's review this. What we have done is we did this and this last class. So if you look at the top of an orbit. So let's in general discuss elliptical orbit. Okay. This is your elliptical orbit. This is where the central body is, and this would be your R. So you can say M1, M2, and this is the orbit vertical part. Okay. So if you have M1 here, your M2 would be orbiting. And this R is given by the orbit equation. And this is your angle theta, okay, always. Now what we are saying here is R is minimum when, if you just look at the orbit equation itself, R equal to h square over mu into 1 over 1 plus E cosine theta. This R is minimum when theta is, or when theta is maximum. Because this is constant, okay, E is constant, the only variable is theta. If you look at the orbit equation, everything is constant. So this is the other form of the orbit equation, where P is h square over mu. R is minimum when this denominator is maximum. So denominator maximum means the theta should be maximum. Or, sorry, cosine theta should be maximum. This should be maximum. Okay. So what is the maximum value of cosine? 1, right. So if you see, the maximum value of cosine theta is 1, and that happens when theta is equal to 0. Okay. So this distance, when theta is equal to 0, this point is called the point of closest approach, or it's called periapsis. And this distance, this is RP now. RP becomes, RP is equal to a square over mu into 1 over 1 plus E. Cosine theta is 1. Okay. Similarly, the point of farthest approach would be this. And that happens when cosine theta is minimum. Okay. R is maximum when cosine theta is minimum. cosine theta is the minimum. The minimum value of cosine theta is negative 1, right? So minimum value of negative 1, that occurs at theta equal to 180 degrees. So this is your RA, which is Z. And this point, the point of farthest approach, is called the apoapsis. So if you combine these two, you can get an expression for E, eccentricity E, in terms of the periapsis radius and the apoapsis radius, or the distance between the apoapsis and the central body, and the distance between the periapsis and the central body. So you could be asked to, let's say, starting with the orbit equation, derive an expression for RP or E. So you could, if you are asked to derive an expression for E in terms of RA and RP, your first step is this, your second step is this, and then you add those two and show that E is that value. Okay. So it's this distance plus this distance over this distance minus this distance. E is, you can express generally E is, if you look at a conic section, E is expressed as, eccentricity is expressed as in terms of major and minor axis. This one? Yeah, that is R. That is the distance R. It depends. It is actually, it's not only for circle, it's not only for ellipse. It is, there are three, four conic sections here. So E varies for different things. So when you're finally, let's talk about this a little bit, okay? I'll give you a more, see, you can look this up, or let me, I'll give you a more meaningful explanation for E. It's essentially a ratio, some ratio of the minor and major axis. It's how it's defined. Okay. But this is another way of expressing your E. Okay. Flight path angle is again a very important concept. So what is flight path angle? If you have, this is, let's say, M1, okay? And let's say this is M2, right? Flight path angle, the normal to the radius vector. This is generally called the local horizon. The normal to the radius vector. So in this case, what would be the normal? Just the perpendicular. Okay? So I would draw something like this. Okay? This would be the local horizon. And the angle made by the velocity vector, this angle so this is your velocity vector, this angle gamma made between the local horizon and velocity vector is the, you guys have to go through the cell phone, huh? Is it really that important?
I mean, it's as it is, it is difficult to follow. Why do you have to go through the cell phone? So this angle is called local horizon, okay? Now this, sorry, this normal is, normal to the radius vector is the local horizon, and the angle made by the velocity vector with this local horizon is flight path angle, okay? This local horizon can be represented using this tangential component of the velocity, right? That's what we have looked at. So if I expand this a little bit more, this would be local horizon, okay, M1, M2. So this is perpendicular, all right? If this is your velocity vector, what direction is the, what direction is VR? This is the R direction, okay? So your VR would be in this direction, and this would be your V perpendicular direction always, right? So if you're looking at that, can you, what is the angle now? What is the angle gamma? This is that angle, right? Gamma. So do you see gamma as VR over V perpendicular? Tangent. So if I expand this, this is V perpendicular. Sorry, this is VR. V perpendicular, and this is gamma. So you see tangent gamma is equal to VR over V perpendicular. Okay. We often need to use this expression to figure out where we are, local horizon and flight path angle. Okay. So you may be asked to just describe the flight path angle. What is the flight path angle? How would you determine the flight path angle? Okay. So you should be able to express the flight path angle with just a simple schematic of the orbit. So this would be your orbit or path. Okay. So final one is, let's do the energy equation or conservation of total, yes. The velocity direction.
Velocity direction.
Mm-hmm. And the local right. See, you'll never see the, you'll never see a satellite going in this direction. You'll always see the satellite going in this direction. Why is that? Huh?
Gravity.
So this part, it is always trying to compensate gravity. So it's trying to just resist. This part is only trying to resist gravity. Okay. So this, so it is this component is cancelled off due to gravity. So you're going to see the satellite going in this direction. But the true velocity, what is that true velocity? The true velocity is actually this, or the complete velocity of the orbiting satellite. It's not necessarily the flight path, right? So recall, okay. This is the two-body relative motion problem. Dot with R dot. Either side. Okay. So what you're going to end up is R double dot dotted with R dot. Plus mu over cube zero. Equal to minus mu over Q. Left hand side R dotted with R dot is equal to half d over dt. So what I'm saying, what we are saying here is, we can write the left-hand side as this. Okay. If you do a little bit of math on this one, what you're going to get is, you're going to get R double dot, right, plus R double dot dotted with R dot, right. No? The product rule applied to that product. Okay. So d over dt, think about this, d over dt of r dotted with r is equal to this. This would be 2 times. You can write, since it's dot product is commutative, you can write R dot dotted with R. Right? So this half, 2 and half cancels off, and you still end up with this. Got it? Huh? Say it again. started with this, okay? So this would be, let's say, do this. You see, this can be, I'm saying, we are saying this can be expressed as this. So this. Okay. Huh? Okay. So, you see, if you take the derivative of this, this into derivative of that plus derivative of this into this. Okay. If it's cross product, it is anti commutative. So this would be, you can write this as half d over dt. So what you're going to get here is this is essentially v dotted with v. Okay. What is v dotted with v? Half d over dt. The scalar v square, or this is equal to d over dt half v square. Okay. Now, right hand side minus mu over r cube is equal to mu r r dot over r cube, which is equal to mu r dot over r square. Okay. Remember this expression. This was on the homework. A vector dotted with itself is equal to scalar into, or vector dotted with its derivative is equal to scalar into its scalar derivative. This was also part of your extra credit for the exam. So let's discuss that later. So if you look at this, one of this r cancels with this r cube. Okay, so you're going to get r dot over r square. Now this can be written minus mu r over r dot over r square can be written as d over dt of mu over r. So if I just take off this, sorry, so if you, this, so mu r dot over r square can be written as minus d over dt of mu over r. Okay, if again, I can do that, I can show you here that d over dt of, let's say, minus mu over r is equal to what? So it's, what is the derivative of 1 over r? That is the integration, right? You're talking about the integration. So it's, right, minus d over dt mu over r square into r dot, right? Because r is an implicit variable, it's a time variable. You need to get that r dot in the denominator. This is a time variable, right? Here, you use like a chain rule. So you get minus This is what you're going to get, end up with, okay? And now you compare this and this, so you can write this as. Combining these results, yes, Sam. Let's say this is C, and this is D. Say it again. R. So I've shown you here. I'm saying this, we're saying this can be written as this. And why? The proof is here. What are you going to get? R dot into R double dot plus R dot into R double dot. Yeah. So you can, this, since this is commutative, you can say it's just R dot, two times R dot dotted with R double dot, R double dot dotted with R dot.
Okay.
So if you combine, get half d over dt of d over dt of half b square minus of mu over r is equal to 0. Okay. So if you look at this, or you can say half v square minus mu over r is equal to e, where e is a constant. Just a minute.
Okay.
E is a constant, okay? And it is called conservation of total mechanical energy. Okay. So what you're seeing here is, see, this is the, what is the expression for kinetic energy? You remember half mv square? So this is specific kinetic energy. Okay. And this is specific potential energy. We'll discuss about why the negative sign, but you can look at this as total kinetic energy plus total potential energy is equal to this. And we have shown that this E is constant. This shows that this is constant. Okay? So you're essentially saying the total mechanical energy is always conserved. You have to remember that energy is a scalar or a vector. Energy is a scalar, okay? If you had it as a vector, you would have seen it as a vector. You don't see vectors here, right? All these are scalar quantities. So what it says is, we said there are 10 constants of motion. We developed 3 constants of motion from the conservation of angular momentum. And this is one constant, okay? You have 4 constants. We need to derive 6 more constants, which we'll discuss in the next class.